Hello friends, in this video lecture, we will try to understand communication model. Basically, network management has four types of basic model. First one is organization model, second is information model, third is communication model, and fourth is functional model. Now we have to understand what it means by communication model. Every model is able to give us some specific function. For example, organization model will give us design of the network. Information model will tell us the idea about management of data which we require to send from a particular host to other host inside the network. Now we are discussing about the communication model. It addresses the model associated with the ways of information exchanged between the systems. That means once you are having data in your hand, then data is nothing but what? Information. Information or data is important when we require to design the network, because definition of network itself, the connected like this, as well as communicated device. So communicated device means when we try to transmit the data from one device to other device. So communication, if I want to establish, I must have to manage data which I require to transmit from one source to other destination. So exchange of the information or exchange of the data is nothing but the representation of communication model. Now, what it means by data? Data is nothing but the input which is in the hand of sender. Always sender will send some data and receiver will only able to receive that particular data. So whenever the sender required to send something, then that information which they have to send and the information which receiver has to receive, that should be in the different form. For example, that can be in the form of audio, that can be in the form of video, it can be in the form of image, it can be in the form of number. So there are multiple ways to represent the data. But the main thing, if I'm having the data in my hand, then how can I exchange the data? Who is responsible to transmit the data and who is responsible to receive the data? In general, we are going to talk about sender is responsible to transmit the data and receiver is responsible to receive the data. But in the theoretical world, in the network management, the sender is replaced by manager and receiver is replaced by agent. When manager is at uppermost layer than that of agent. So here arrow direction should be like this. Now, if agent is also able to send something to the other devices, then that other devices will be the lowermost layer to the agent. So after agent, I can write down here resources. So now the resources are become receiver and agent is become now sender. For this particular communication exchange, agent is receiver and manager is sender. That means indirectly, network management will tell us the idea about the different sender and different receiver, when they will act as a sender and when they will act as a receiver. So network elements are arranged with the help of organization model. This is the responsibility of organization model to organize the infrastructure of each and every network element. After that, information model will try to manage the data and this communication model will try to exchange the data. That means the actual communication can be started with the help of communication model. Now, information exchange between the system is the main purpose behind the communication model. The agent executes the request on the network element, that is managed object, and returns response to the manager. Now, we have to understand what it means by managed object. So, managed object means the object which will tries to follow protocol. Protocol are nothing but rules and regulations which are required to make the communication more successful, or efficiency of a particular communication we can increase with the help of use of the protocol. Also, the managed objects will be controllable, or we can say they are manageable. That means indirectly, if there is agent and there are if resources, then now agent is become uppermost device. So resources should be the managed object, so that the agent can able to control them. And resources, that means indirectly managed object, will try to follow all the rules and regulations which are required to make the communication more successful. So it is very important to purge or to design a network with the help of managed object. And hence, because of these two advantage of managed objects, they are more expensive than that of the unmanaged objects. Now, what are the managed objects? Hub, bridge, router, switch, these all can be the characterized in between the managed element and unmanaged element. So we have to purge to design any network, we require to buy all the managed elements, and which are very much expensive than that of the unmanaged elements. But once we will try to purge them, then our efficiency of communication will be surely increases. So always here the agent execute the request on the network element, that is the managed object. So always everyone required the managed object and returns response to the manager. The notification and traps are the answer located message generated by the agent. Now, what it means by notification? Many times we are getting notifications after the completion of a particular call. We get the notification from the particular agent, like our recharge or the balance is this for such kind of time duration. So these are the notifications. Sometimes they are useful for us so that we can remind ourselves that yes, we required to recharge our particular mobile SIM card. But sometimes that notifications may not be useful. They can be the irritating. So such kind of notifications can be also known as unsolicited message. So unsolicited message, the meaning of the unsolicited is unwanted message. So whatever the notifications or traps, traps are nothing but the unsolicited message. So whatever the notifications or traps are there, they can be sent along with the response to the sender. Now we have to understand exactly who is sender and who is receiver in the network management system. Try to understand, anyone can be sender or can be receiver if they are able to control the below system. So that now we will try to understand the basic model of the communication. So this is our basic model of communication, where we are having two models in our hand. One is manager and one is agent. Now we can understand here, the manager is acts as a sender and agent acts as a receiver. So what will manager try to generate? Operation or request. That means he will try to select this receiver and he will try to first of all generate an operation, or it can be a request. Now, whenever he will try to send it, then the arrow direction is from sender to receiver. Receiver will receive it. Now here agent is nothing but what? Receiver. Receiver will receive it, and if he is ready to receive the required data which is sent or transmitted from sender, then he will try to submit response. So here operation or request is related the thing which sender wants to send. That means sender will try to generate a request to set or establish the communication. Then if receiver is ready to receive what sender wants to send, he will try to submit the response. Response is nothing but ready for receiver. So this is nothing but what? Response. Along with the response, I already told you, they are able to send notifications or traps. Notifications may or may not be useful. When they are not useful, they can treat as unsolicited, that is unwanted message. But yes, agents are, that means receivers are able to send the notification or trap. Now this is the model where manager try to access sender and agent try to access receiver. Now for begin the process, manager has some data which he wants to send to receiver. Receiver will try to show the identity of the sender. Receiver will try to identity of sender. Once he will try to understand the identity of sender, he can imagine whatever data the sender can send him that can be the useful or not. So that he will try to send the response. Along with that, he will try to send notifications or trap. Now, in the second scenario, if agent is sender and if manager is receiver or any other thing which is resources or customers are receiver, then exactly we require to draw the opposite diagram, or we can exchange or replace the place of sender and receiver. This is the simple thing behind the basic communication model. Next thing is, there are three aspects need to address in between the communication of information between two entities. What are the two entities? One is sender and one is receiver. So our previous diagram indirectly. So if there should be the basic communication established in between the two entities, then there are few aspects of the communication and that we have to follow. First one is transport medium of message exchange in the transport protocol. Now we have already familiar about the transport layer protocol or session layer protocol and all that things. So protocols are nothing but rules and regulations which we must have to use for making the successful communication. Now transport protocol is one of the protocol which will try to give their own set of rules and regulations. And once the communication must establish in between the two entities, they have to follow the rule of the transport protocol indirectly. This is the first aspects of communication model. Second is message format of communication in the application protocol. Like a transport protocol, OSI layer having, OSI model having 7 layers. After that, TCP/IP model having 5 layers. And finally, our TMA, that is Telecom Network Management, is having few layers that we have to study in this particular subject. But the basic communication model cannot be changed. So always we have to follow the basic layer and their protocol. So the message format of communication should be as per the set of rules and regulations which are set in the application protocol. This is the second aspect. The third one is the actual message known as command and response. Whatever we try to transmit, we have to transmit with the help of command and required to receive with the help of response indirectly. Once you will try to send something or you will receive something, that notifications you have to transmit with the help of command and response, and that can be known as the actual message. The application in the manager model initiates the request to agent in the internal model. Now, the internet model and the initiate or the manager model can be the different things. One is the sender, one is the receiver. We can state the name, different name, theoretical words for that particular thing. So whenever we will talk about the basic model of the communication, there should be the manager and agent, that word we have to use. Whenever we will talk about the original model or the modified model of the communication, then we have to use such kind of words. So along with these three aspects of the communication, we have to follow the rules and regulations which are set by the particular layer and with respect to that by the particular protocol. This is the communication model, or we can say the modified communication model. We have already observed the basic model of communication. Now this is the next part of that model, where we try to show the bidirectional communication in between the two entities. This is one entity indirectly. This is one network, we can say. And this is another one. So this is the first network, this is the second network. If we require to establish a communication, what we have to follow? The three aspects of communications, and which we can follow with the help of protocols at different layers. So what are the different type of protocols that we must have to follow, that we will try to understand after few time. Now, first of all, this is the manager application. Now we require to change the theoretical word manager application instead of only the manager model. Here the agent application. Now after that, because the first one should be the application layer, after that manager communication model, same way agent communication model, and transport layer, which is the basic layer, the first aspect of our communication, that we must have to follow the rules and regulations set by the transport protocol. So here also I have to use the same, the sender and receiver. Anyone can be the sender, anyone can be the receiver, no need to worry about that. Hence we try to show the bidirectional communication here, but the sender and receiver both must contain the same type of the organized layer. So they are lie in the different network or in the same network, no need to worry about it, but they should follow the same protocols. This is the basic idea behind the communication model. So if here they are going to follow the transport layer protocol rules, here also they must have to follow the transport layer protocol. So you can say that these are the two different networks, or you can say that these are the two different hosts. Let us try to comment as a host so that you can understand more easily, because host means the devices which are present in a single network. So if these are the hosts, they will lie in the same network, so that their arrangement of a layer or the following of the protocols can be the same. So transport layer is transport layer, communication model, communication model, application layer, application layer. So just we required to follow who is the manager and who is the agent, or we have to take precaution who is the sender, who is the receiver. Now, what about these protocols? I already told you, we have to follow the three aspects of communication. That is what? Transport layer protocol, application layer protocol, that we must have to follow. And the last one is internet model. That means the internet protocol. So now we have to find out what are the protocols which we can use with respect to such kind of layers. The first one is UDP, that is User Datagram Protocol. It is a transport layer protocol. So the first layer that is used for the communication, and that was the first aspect of the communication model, that is nothing but the transport layer, and its protocol is nothing but User Datagram Protocol, which we have to use. UDP is a part of Internet Protocol Suite referred as UDP-IP. Whenever we try to use the same kind of the protocol in the TCP-IP or in the internet model, then that is known as UDP-IP. Unlike TCP, it is unreliable and connectionless protocol. So, it is unreliable and it is connectionless protocol. These are the basic properties of UDP. So, there is no need to establish the connection prior to the data transfer. So, connectionless means wireless protocol. So, no need to establish any kind of wired or the physical connection. But instead of establishing all this connection, there is a possibility of communication. So, it is useful and hence we have to follow this kind of protocol at the basic layer. Second one is CIMP, that is Common Management Information Protocol, and that we are getting from OSI layer. So this is the basic model of the communication. So what are the features of CIMP that we have to understand? International Standard Organization deals with the 7 layers of OSI model. It is most object-oriented protocol. It is well-structured and well-layered. These are the advantage or the features of CIMP. It consumes large resources in the implementation management of data communication network in local area network and wide area network. So, where we can use this particular protocol to connect or to design LAN, that is the local area network, its capacity is from that should be more than 0 and that should be less than 10 kilometer. After that, we can generate or design MAN whose capacity is from 10 kilometer to 100 kilometer. After that, we can use or generate the WAN whose capacity is start from 100 kilometer and that can be end to the 1000 kilometer. So, what is the use of CIMP? Though it is going to use the large number of resources, it will try to enhance the large network area also. So, what we can design along with that? Most probably, it is useful to design LAN and WAN kind of the networks. So, it is suitable with the help of this protocol. Hence, it is known as the Common Management Information Protocol. So, designing of the large or the huge number of resources can be easily possible. So, if I want to communicate or if I want to establish a communication between the number of resources inside the network, then I can easily use the Common Management Information Protocol from the OSI layer. So, the second protocol that we will try to use in the communication module, that is OSI/CIMP. Then, the next protocol which is from internet model, that is SNMP. SNMP stands for Simple Network Management Protocol. The name itself indicates that its implementation is very simple as compared to all other protocols. Now, SNMP, who tried to generate this particular protocol? Internet Engineering Task Force, IETF, they are responsible to develop this particular protocol. It is originally intended or developed for the management of internet components and currently adopted for wide area network. That means the application of SNMP is again to establish wide area network. Now, IETF industry, that is Internet Engineering Task Force industry, developed this protocol which is very easy to implement or to design in wide area network. Hence, the name is Simple Network Management Protocol. as we have to establish the communication in between the multiple modules or in between the multiple network elements which are active and present inside the network, we can go and we can use SNMP. So, the three aspects of communication can be utilized with the help of three different types of protocols that we try to study. The protocol names are UDP from basic models of communication. It can be UDP-IP if it is used from the internet model. After that, we have studied CIMP from OSI model, and last one is SNMP from internet model. So because of their these features and their application, we can use them in the communication model to establish a communication between the two entities, that can be manager agent, that can be agent resources, and so on. So in this way, there are two types of communication model. One is basic communication model, in which you can fix or finalize the sender and receiver. And second is the modified, which is known as the communication model, in which you can show the models of sender and receiver with the bidirectional communication along with all the three aspects of communication indirectly, all the three different type of protocol use. Thank you.